Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Now, let us understand some important points in this. In this, you can see that when the flow is, let us say, steady flow, we have already understood what is the steady flow. Moment you talk about steady and unsteady, you are talking about the change in time. Okay, so if there is no change in time, then it is steady flow. So if there is no change in time, what will happen to your acceleration, temporal acceleration? It is going to zero. The dou u by dou t term is going to be zero. So now similarly, if it is a uniform flow, there is no change in the spatial direction. You have at a particular time over the space, there is no change. So the change in the velocity between two points is going to be zero. So dou u by dou x is going to be zero. So if you multiply that with u, v, w, whatever it is, it's going to be zero. So your spatial or convective acceleration is going to be zero for uniform flow. All right. So similarly, now if I say I have a steady flow and a uniform flow, then the total acceleration is going to be zero. All right. So having understood this, let us now look at different types of flow and which acceleration is going to be present. So now this is what my type of flow on left side, and on right side I am writing material acceleration. Now if I want to write it, I have two components. One is temporal acceleration, one is convective acceleration. Now tell me, if there is a steady uniform flow, which we have already discussed just now, what will be the temporal acceleration and what will be the convective acceleration? They will be zero, both. Okay, so temporal acceleration is zero, convective acceleration is zero. And similarly, if I take steady non-uniform flow, you should be able to immediately tell that the moment you say steady, temporal acceleration is zero and non-uniform flow, so the convective acceleration is going to exist. Okay, so similarly for a unsteady uniform flow, unsteady, so temporal acceleration will remain uniform, convective acceleration will be zero. So temporal acceleration exists, convective acceleration will be zero. And if it is unsteady non-uniform flow, then both these accelerations will remain and total acceleration is going to be derived considering both these components. All right. So when we want to find out or solve a fluid flow problem, that time we need to know which component will remain or which will not remain, which will exist or which will not exist. That will possibly simplify our problem. Okay. And you can understand and derive the equations accordingly. All right. Now let us understand how we define various flow lines. As we have discussed, there are number of flow lines. So we talked about something called streamline, and we'll also look at path lines, we'll also look at streak lines, but let us first understand the streamlines, which is very, very important, and you will see a lot of applications of that. Now a streamline at any instant can be defined as an imaginary curve or line in the flow field. So you have a flow field, and within that, obviously you cannot draw a line. So you imagine that there is a line, and if there is a line, what is the property of this line or this streamline? That the tangent to this curve at any point, I have a curve, and at this, along this curve, at any point, I draw a tangent that gives me the direction of instantaneous velocity at that point. Okay. So if I have the instantaneous velocity of that point along the streamline, then obviously that is the flow velocity direction. So I cannot have any velocity normal to that, because that's the resultant velocity or the direction of the instantaneous velocity. So there is no other velocity. At each point, I have this instantaneous velocity along the streamline. So that means at all these points there is no transverse velocity. All right, so there cannot be any flow across the streamline. The flow is taking place along the streamline, and in many cases these lines are also called the flow lines. Okay, so streamlines are imaginary lines or imaginary curve on which you take any point, the tangent at that point represents the direction of the instantaneous velocity at that point. Okay, so the streamlines are basically the geometrical representation of the flow velocity, which I just now said that you can draw the streamline, and that represents how the flow is taking place, or this is basically the flow lines. Okay, so geometrical representation of the flow velocity. So you can draw number of streamlines, and that will show you the flow or the kind of a flow path of certain number of particles. Okay, so how they are moving. So let us say this figure, what you see here is typically you have this fluid here and that is moving. So all the particles, if you draw the streamlines, you can draw and you can come to another cross section. So there is going to be no flow coming into this domain. So if they are the stream, this is a stream tube. Okay, so it's kind of a tube, and there is no flow going out of this, no flow coming inside this. Okay, so these lines which we see are the streamlines, and these are the tangential velocities at any point that you want to draw. Okay, so in an unsteady flow, velocity vector changes with time. The pattern of streamlines will change, or it also changes from one time to the other time. But at a particular time instant, you can have one stream tube, and this stream tube could have a different position. At this time it is like this. So at this time there is no flow to this domain from any side. It is through this tube only. And if you go to the other instant, because the velocities have changed, there could be some change in the stream tube profile. So you might see another profile. So that is possible, but at a particular time it does not change. Okay, and if you look at that, the lines that we are drawing, we said that there is no cross flow. So if there is no cross flow, one streamline cannot cross another streamline. Okay, so streamlines cannot cross each other in this case. All right, so we'll see all those properties at a later stage. So in a steady flow, the orientation or the pattern of streamlines are going to be fixed, because in a steady flow your flow field is not changing in time. So if you have drawn streamline, it is not going to change because the flow field is not changing or the velocities are not changing. So the streamline position is not going to change. Okay, now if I want to write down that mathematically, I can write down V cross ds is equals to zero. Okay, because the perpendicular to that, the velocity is normal to this streamline is zero. So I can write down V cross ds equals to zero. And if you see, V is the instantaneous velocity vector and ds is your length of infinitesimal line segment. So if I take any small line segment, this is my ds. Okay, this is my ds, and the velocity for that segment is V. Okay, so if I take the V cross ds, obviously I'm going to get zero. Now if I write down the vectorial form, the velocity in velocity as u, v and w in x, y and z directions respectively, so I can write down iu, jv and kw, where I, j and k are the unit normals or unit vectors in x, y and z directions respectively. All right, now similarly, if we write down the ds, the delta s will also have components in x, y and z directions. So I can write down that as delta x, delta y and delta z, or dx, dy, dz. So I will write down that as s equals to I dx j dy k dz. All right. So if you take the cross product of this, what do you get? You get dx by u is equals to dy by v is equals to dz by w. All right. So this is what is going to be your equation if you solve this mathematical expression. Now, the stream function is derived only for a 2D case. So it can be solved for a 2D problem, whether it is XY plane or YZ plane or ZX plane, whatever it is, it can be solved for a 2D plane. So which we will see in more details at a later stage. But when we are telling that it can be solved for a 2D case, let us say it is XY. For that, we can write down the expression as dx by u is equals to dy by v, or dy by dx is going to be equals to v by u. So basically, the slope of the streamline is given by dy by dx, which is nothing but your v by u. All right. Now let us see a stream tube, which I have already explained. Basically, the bundle of neighboring streamlines may be imagined to form a passage through which the fluid flows. So if I say this, there is my streamlines are this, which is represented here. So this passage is nothing but your stream tube, which is again imaginary. Okay. And the stream tube is bounded on all sides of the streamlines. As I have already said, the fluid velocities does not exist across the streamlines. There cannot be cross flow. So no fluid may enter or leave the stream tube except at the ends. Okay. So at these ends, that is the cross section, there could be fluid entering here and fluid exiting here, but there cannot be any flow. There cannot be any flow from the lateral directions. Okay. All right. Okay. So now the entire flow in a flow field may be imagined to be composed of flow through stream tubes arranged in some arbitrary positions. Okay. So we have understood the stream lines, and we understood that the tangent at any point on the streamline is going to give you the velocity. There is no cross flow. And if you take a stream tube, this kind of a passage, so there cannot be any flow coming into this tube from the lateral directions or going out of this tube in the lateral directions. There can be only flow coming in at the ends. Okay. And the entire flow in the flow field can be imagined to be composed of flow through a stream tube arranged in some arbitrary position. That means you have a domain, so you can have multiples of stream tubes and the flow is taking place through those stream tubes. Okay. So there are a lot of applications of this. We'll see the application at a later stage. Now let us look at the next type of lines that we discussed is the path line. What is path line? Path line is the actual path traveled by the fluid particle over a period of time. So it is reminding us of the Lagrangian frame of reference, isn't it? So you are tracking the fluid particle and you are tracking how it moves in time. So it is the path that has been taken by this fluid element over a period of time. So that is, that line if I draw is called the path line. If you look at this figure, you can see that, let us say P1. P1 starts from here and it goes all the way and takes a loop and then comes, reaches here. So that is my path line for P1. Similarly for P2, this fluid particle starts from here and it goes something like this. So it is P2, and P3 comes from here and it goes like this. So I cannot restrict how this fluid particle is going to move. So they can cross each other. There can be a loop and it can move in any direction or any random manner, depending on the flow properties. Okay. So if I want to write in mathematical expression, I know the start position, initial position, and then I will find out what is the velocity. So based on the velocity, I'll find out the new position. So new position is x plus delta x, and that delta x is going to be v dt. Okay. So integration over v v dt is going to give you the delta x. That will give you the new position. New position is x. Okay. So we can write down this expression. X is equals to x zero or x start plus integration over t zero start time to delta t. T is varying with some additional, or you are moving in time with delta t. So that is integrated over this time to this time v dt. So that will give you the new position x. So you can keep on tracking the position all through the movement. So the family of path lines represent the trajectories of different particles, which we see here in this figure. Okay. So the family of path lines are basically showing you the paths that are taken by different particles. And in a steady flow, the path lines are identical to streamlines. Okay. In a steady flow, the flow properties are not changing, so they will keep on moving in that same path, and there will not be any change in time, so they will be identical to the streamlines. Okay, path lines can intersect each other, and a path line can form a loop, and it can cross its own path maybe once or several times depending on the motion. Okay, so there is a distinction between the streamline and path line. Now let us look at what is streak line. Okay, so the next type is streak line. What is streak line? If you look at streak line, is the locus of fluid particles that have passed sequentially through a prescribed point in the flow. Let us say I have a particular point which is shown here as P. Okay, this point is P. And in time, as the time moves, let us say t1, t2, t3. So at t1, my particle q moves, okay, and t2, particle r moves, t3, particle s moves through this point, and q goes through this point, and it reaches here after some time, and r, which has gone at some time t, it reaches at this point, and S reaches at this point. Now that time t is tn, t plus delta t, some time in instant after the fluid's particles passed through this point I'm looking at. So if I join the points where these particles have reached, I can find out this profile. Okay, this is nothing but my streak line. Okay, to give you an example of that, I'll show you the same movie which you have shown you earlier, and in that you can see, let us say, okay, now let us say this is the location through which the particles have passed, okay, and they are moving. So I can track now which are the locations these particles are going to reach after some time. Okay, and I will move this again further. See, this line, outer line, let us say the particle at the outer line are constant, they are not moving inside or whatever. So this line is nothing but a new profile of these particle positions. So if I join this, I can still call it as a streak line. Okay, so this is slightly something you have to imagine. Okay, and you can still see where the new positions of these particles are, and you can join them to get the streak line. So there are applications of streak lines, but not so much as of streamlines and path lines. Okay. So in this case, we saw that these profiles, these are the path lines, and each one of them, A, B, C, shows the path line for Q, R, S. And if I join these positions Q, R, S at a particular time, then I will get the streak lines. All right. So in this lecture, we have understood the basics of fluid kinematics, starting from various flow fields, and how to define scalar, vector, and vector field, scalar field, and so on. Then we have seen various properties of accelerations, material derivative, and then we have seen different flow lines that have stream lines, streak lines, path lines. Okay, so with this we'll end the lecture here. We'll take the next concept in the next lecture. So thank you so much. Have a good day.